We know harassment isn't just something that happens to women and girls. Men and boys can be victims of it as well. So I think we need to broaden that language.
It's more of an issue of power.
Absolutely.
In a broader sense, right?
Absolutely. It's an issue of power. It's an issue of presumption. It's an issue of privilege.
We asked Peggy Andrews, management professor at the Hamline University School of Business, what has led to the chorus of voices rising in the Me Too movement.
Just collectively, we're at kind of an interesting nexus point where people can talk about what's happening to them and not feel isolated in doing it.
She says it starts with the impact of new digital media.
I'm not an expert on the Anita Hill situation, but I think she had to seek out a pathway to tell her story versus now somebody can videotape themselves, put it on YouTube, put it on Facebook, and they can go viral really, really quickly. And once it's said, it lives on into infinity out in the internet.
Andrews points to more safety nets at work, with workplaces evolving to have conversations and concrete action when it comes to sexual harassment.
And so we've developed a language of differences. So it's not just this monolithic language of the good old boys club, and this is what it means to be at work. And so workplaces are being much more intentional around having a culture of respect, and then they're backing that up with formal policies. They're training their employees, and then there's actually consequences. We're seeing actual consequences happen, which makes people feel safer in coming forward.
Lindsay Sievert, CARE 11 News.